one has fulfilled his task and delivered his trust. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد. Dear brothers in Islam, Quran is the word of God, it is the ultimate truth. And the guidance revealed to his Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام is the best guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us in the Quran to remain conscious of him and promised those who remain conscious of him great reward in this life and the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَالْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. O you who believe, remain conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and look at what you have done for your tomorrow. And remain conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows all what you are doing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. This is the reward in this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that whoever remains conscious of Allah will always find an exit of his adversity or difficulty. Whenever we meet a calamity or an adversity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open us a door to get out of it. He will make it easy for us to be delivered of our adversity. وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And this is something that every human being is keen on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are, as human beings, the first thing that concerns us is how to earn our living. We look for how to get our provisions, to feed ourselves, feed our families, and so on. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if you remain conscious of Him, He will provide for you from whatever you did not expect. And again, it's not only a reward in this life, but it's also in the hereafter. Those are muttaqoon, those who remain conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are loved by Allah. And He will reward them in the hereafter greatly. Today, inshallah, I'd like to talk a little bit about our great book, Al-Quran, our amazing miracle, Al-Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us a great guidance and a great glad tidings by giving the Quran to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. When you read the Quran, you find descriptions of the Quran in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. O people, and this is addressed to all people, قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent you an admonition. The admonition is in the Quran. وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. This admonition brings healing to the hearts. وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And it is a guidance and a mercy for those who believe in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls the Quran a book of guidance. He calls it a mercy. And he states that there is healing there. And the word healing has been mentioned couple of times in the Quran, around the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. We reveal this Quran and it contains healing and mercy for the believers. But it increases the loss of the disbelievers, of those who reject the Quran. So the Quran is a guide, book of guidance. It is a book of mercy. It is a book of healing. It is a book of light. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He has revealed this light to His Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam to be able to guide people to the straight path. We need to understand this, and we need to appreciate this, and we need to benefit out of this. Quran is the book of salvation. The Quran is the book that will save us from misery in this life and from torment in the hereafter. So it has to be part of our life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent that Quran for us to read, to understand, to reflect on its meaning, and to use it as a manual for our life. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do in the Quran, we should do. And whatever He says, do not do, we shouldn't do. And that's the way we have to deal with the Quran. And the starting point is to recite the Quran. We need to make recitation of the Quran a part of our life. Just like we eat and drink and do everything in our daily life, reciting the Quran should also have time in our busy day. We should dedicate a certain amount of time to read the Quran and to contemplate its meanings and to try and endeavor to apply its injunctions. But at least we should not abandon the Quran, because if we do not read the Quran, if we only treat the Quran as a blessing that we put in our homes or in our cars, then we have abandoned the Quran. The blessings in the Quran can be only obtained by reciting the Quran. And if we can, we can memorize some of the Quran. There are many hadith that tells us about the benefit of those who recite the Quran and who memorize the Quran. And the benefits, again, just like anything in Islam, Islam does not focus only on this life and neglects the hereafter, and does not only focus on the hereafter and neglects this life. The divine project, the project that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has devised for us to live according to, combines a balance of caring for this life and caring for the hereafter. Just like the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, when he said that work for your this life as if you are going to live forever, and work for the hereafter as if you are going to die tomorrow. So we need to have that balance. So when we talk about the benefits of the Quran, we see that there are benefits that we can gain in this life, and there are benefits in the hereafter. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام tells us, مجتمع قوم في بيت من بيوت الله يتلون كتاب الله ويتدارسونه بينهم إلا نزلت عليهم السكينة وغشيتهم الرحمة وحفتهم الملائكة وذكرهم الله في من هم. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says, when a group of people come together in one of the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reciting the Quran and studying it, understanding what its meaning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bestow His tranquility on them. He will bring down tranquility and calmness on their hearts, and they will be encompassed or engulfed with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The angels would be sitting around them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention them in the higher host. What else can we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do for us? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam gives the example of those who recite the Quran and those who do not recite the Quran. He says that the believer who recites the Quran is like utruja, is like a citron, is like a fruit that has good taste and good smell. Outward and inward. The believer who does not recite the Quran is like a date. But a date has a good taste, but it doesn't have a smell. So there is no this outward light that comes from the Quran. The believer who does not recite the Quran is deprived from. But he still has the good and the sound inner core. The hypocrite who recites the Quran is like the rihanna, is like an aromatic plant. It has a good smell, but it has a bitter taste. And finally, the munafiq, the hypocrites, who does not recite the Quran, is right like the handal. The handal is a plant that has no taste and has no smell. Or it has a bitter taste and no smell. So which one of these we would like to be? We want to be like the believer who recites the Quran, so that we get the sound core and we get the beautiful and nice smell of reciting the Quran. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam tells us that the best of you is the one who learns the Quran and teaches the Quran. One of the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam tells us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises the status of people in this life according to how much they know about the Quran. There is a story about Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab. He deputized someone to collect the zakah from people. And that person was a freed slave. He was a slave and then he was freed. And Sayyidina Umar asked him to, or assigned him to do this duty. And someone of the companions came to Sayyidina Umar and said, "Who is this guy? Why are you employing him? Can't you find someone better than him?" And Sayyidina Umar said, "He memorized the Quran and he knows it well. He knows all the obligations that are mentioned in the Quran. These are the elements of success in doing that job. To be muttaqi, recite memorizing the Quran, and to be knowledgeable about what to do and what not to do." And he said, Omar said to the other man who is criticizing his decision, he said, "I heard the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises the status, uses the Quran to raise the status of people, and uses the Quran to abase people in this life. Those who abandon the Quran are debased. Those who are reciting and memorizing the Quran are being raised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." All of these benefits, I'm telling you, are things that we can enjoy in this life. There are a lot more in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, "Iqra'u al-Qur'ana fa'innahu ya'ti yawm al-qiyamah shafi'an li-ashabi." Recite the Quran because it will come on the day of judgment to intercede on your behalf. It will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you, and it will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you a good reward. And in particular, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam talked about Surah Al-Baqarah and Surah Ali Imran. And he said, whoever memorized these two surahs, they will come on the day of judgment just like a cloud, protecting the person from the heat of hellfire and the heat of the sun. And they will intercede on behalf of the person to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran, those who memorize the Quran, will come on the day of judgment, and the Quran will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "This man or this woman memorized the Quran. So please Allah, give him something good. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will dress him with the dress of Quran or nobility, and will give him a crown of nobility. All of this because he memorized the Quran in his life. And finally, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam tells us that مثل الذي يقرأ القرآن وهو حافظ له مع السفرة الكرام البر. The example of a person who recites the Quran and memorizes it is a member of the group of the angels on the day of judgment. And those who read it with difficulty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them twice the reward. One reward for reciting the Quran and one reward for having difficulty in reciting the Quran. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم وادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين. I advise you and myself to say salam and salat to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to do this every time we can, and especially on the day of Friday, because every time that we have we say salah and salam to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, we will get a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam will be able to respond to our salam. Allahumma ighfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat wal muslimina wal muslimat al ahya' minhum wal amwat. Allahumma arfa' maqtaka wa ghadabaka 'anna. Allahumma innaka 'afuwwun karimun tuhibbul 'afwa fa'fu 'anna. Allahumma inna nas'aluka bi kulli ismin huwa lak سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك أن تجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا ونور صدورنا وجلاء أحزاننا وهمومنا. اللهم علمنا منه ما جهلنا. اللهم أعنا على قراءة القرآن. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في هذا اليوم العظيم ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا عيبا إلا سترته، ولا دينا إلا قضيته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا ميتا إلا رحمته، ولا حاجة هي لك رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أقم الصلاة.
Allahu Akbar.